You want to rank on the first page of the search engines? You've got to do SERP analysis. Be sure you know what SERP is. It is search engines results page, but why do you need it? Because if you do not tick the checkboxes of what the search engines are looking for, your content won't rank. So in this video, we'll talk about how to do SERP analysis so that your content will rank highly. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress sites, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. So the purpose of SERP analysis is to help businesses, site owners, and digital marketers understand what the search engines are looking for in the content and how search engine displays results for specific keywords or queries. And with that insight, you can optimize your content so that it has a higher chance of ranking on the first page. So let me walk you through the process of SERP analysis and highlight the things you should be looking out for. If your site is new or not as authoritative as your competitors, then choosing the right keywords to create content is going to be the most important task of all. Let me walk you through an example. Let's say that you're starting a website selling exercise equipment, and one of your marketing goals is to drive high quality traffic from the search engines. So you have to brainstorm a list of keywords and start picking the right ones. Now, in this video, I'm not going to show you how to pick the right keywords because we have already talked about it in this video right here. But we are going to focus on the things to look out for before you start writing your content. So let's quickly get a keyword related to our business. Using the keyword planner, you can click on Discover New Keywords, and then click on this to select the country your content is targeting. If your target audience is worldwide, you want to remove every country or region and hit Save, and all locations will be selected. Now we can start with a C keyword. Let's say that you are selling exercise bikes and you want content around that topic. You can type how to star exercise bike. The star right here is a search operator, and it lets Google Keyword Planner know that you want all relevant keywords that starts with how to or a question and ends with something related to exercise bike. So let's hit get results. And here we go. We have how to use Peloton bike at gym, which may not be relevant to our business because we are selling exercise bikes. How to use an exercise bike could be a good keyword. How to buy an exercise bike. How to lose weight on a stationary bike. And I think this is an awesome list because these are the keywords people will search for to find information, and there is an adequate search volume. Now let's assume that we have done our keyword research and this keyword has an adequate search volume and an acceptable level of competition. We are going to write a piece of content on this topic, but first we need to know what type of content and what should we add to the page. Before we move forward, if you want to know how to discover more relevant keywords using the Google Keyword Planner, you can check out this video right here. Anyway, the next step is for you to search for the keyword. Before we search for the keyword, how can I use my bike indoors? Let's take a guess what the keyword is about. I think it is about using the bike I have at home for stationary exercises, but you never know. So let Google tell you what they are looking for. So on Google, let's search for the keyword, how can I use my bike indoors? And straight away, we see the sponsored ads selling items that allow you to convert your bike into a stationary bike. This means that the keyword has some commercial and transactional value or intent, because businesses are bidding for ads to be shown for this keyword. And as a product seller, maybe you want to consider running Google Ads and have your products displayed here, on top of getting ranked organically. Anyway, let's scroll down. We will see a feature snippet, which in SEO terms is position 0, and then the people also are section, followed by the first two organically ranked articles, and then some videos in the video section, followed by the discussions and forum section, and the rest of the ranked articles. Let's see how many organically ranked articles are there in the first page. Let's count position 0 as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. There are a total of 7 organically ranked articles on the first page. So what exactly are we looking for? And how should we do SERP analysis? Let's talk about them. As you know, the SERP for this keyword includes a featured snippet as well as a people also ask section. And this suggests that the keyword has informational search intent, which means users likely want quick information or how-to guide. If you want double confirmation on the search intent of the keyword, you can ask AI. As a RankMath user, you can click on the Contents AI module, then click on the Chat tab, and here's where you can chat with our RankBot. It is trained specifically for content creation and SEO. So you can ask, what is the search intent when someone searches for the keyword, how can I use my bike indoors? Give it a while. And here we go. As you can see, the search intent is informational, which is what we have mentioned earlier. It goes further into saying that the user is seeking guidance on ways to utilize their bike within an indoor setting, and it involves looking for methods to ride their bike indoors. So if you are selling products that align with this intent, then it is perfect. So this keyword has informational intent as well as commercial intent. It goes further to say that the intent may also encompass a broader interest in indoor cycling workouts, maintenance tips, as well as ways to adapt outdoor cycling routines for indoor use. And this gives you an idea to make your content comprehensive. Maybe you can't talk about everything in the same article, but you can have internal links to different pages that will aid the current page on this topic. And if you haven't created these content, then these are great content ideas. I think using AI to verify the intent is super helpful to your content creation. In case you don't know what other search intents there are and you want to learn more about what drives people to search for particular keywords, you can check out this video right here. So it is clear that the content you create for the keyword should be informational. And with the presence of sponsored ads, it tells you that the information you provide can lead to a sale of a product, which is what you are looking for. Now, what else? Let's not forget the presence of videos. This further emphasizes that people may prefer visual content for this query, maybe a tutorial on how to set things up. On top of that, there is the discussion and forum section, which indicates that people are discussing this topic actively, and user-generated content is relevant to the search query. So as a content creator, what can you get out of these insights? Well, you can focus on creating content that answers questions related to the keyword that is short and concise. Provide an answer better than the current featured snippet, as well as better answers for these questions in the People Also Ask section. You should also consider creating video content for this topic and participate in discussions in these threads to gain more exposure. Share your thoughts, opinions, and expertise, and when possible, add links to the content you are creating. But of course, follow the rules of those threads. Most importantly, in your informational content, you should try to introduce products that are highly relevant and helpful to people reading your content. Now, there is one more insight you can get out of the SERP features, which is the competition level. As you already know, there is one featured snippet, 2 higher and 4 lower organic results, which means there are only 7 organic spots on the first page. This means that ranking for the keyword organically is possible, but competitive. And to get real insights to outrank your competition requires you to dig deeper, which is what we're going to talk about next. So when you analyze your organic competitors, what should you be looking out for? The single most important thing to look out for is understanding what the search engine is looking for. I'll give you an example. Someone once came to me for advice about how to rank for the keyword, "Do I need talent to play guitar?" Well, I'm not a guitar expert and I certainly can't answer the question. So whatever that she presented to me makes sense. In the article, she briefly explained that you do not need talent to play guitar, and that's 10% of the content. The remaining 90% of the content is spent on giving a step-by-step tutorial on how to play guitar. I thought that was reasonable. But here's the kicker. When I searched for the keyword, I realized that all the content on the first page talks about all the setbacks a beginner will usually face and provides advice on how to overcome those emotional hurdles. So there is a big disparity between what a writer thought about the topic and what the search engine is actually looking for. If you're writing content that the search engine is not looking for, your content will not rank. So study the different angles of the top competitors and understand what the search engine is looking for. Other than that, you should look at the word count to gauge if the content should be long form or concise. Look at the structure of the content, like the number of headings and subheadings, key takeaways, etc. What are the pages linking to internally and externally, as well as the multimedia use, such as the number of images, videos, or infographics. I want to recommend you to install 2 free Chrome extensions when you're doing SERP analysis. The first is the Keyword Surfer extension. Once you have installed the extension to your Chrome, whenever you do a search, there will be some data right below each search result. It will tell you how many words each article has, how many times the exact match keyword has appeared on a page, and the estimated traffic for the entire domain. But the most important data for this extension is the number of words, because analyzing this data of the top competitors will give you a gauge on the approximate length of your content. And then I recommend that you install another Chrome extension called the Detailed SEO extension. This extension is useful when you visit your competitor's page. As you click on the extension, it will show you the SEO title and description if the page has them, and then the word count, number of headings, images, and links. And if you go to the Headings tab, it will show you the structure of the page, which is what we need. If you analyze a couple more pages, you can know exactly what the search engine is looking for. And then when you click on the Links tab, it will show you all the internal links that are on the page. It is important to analyze the internal links to build context around the topic. That way, you can identify new topics if your website has not covered them. And as you scroll further, you will see all the external links this page is pointing to. Take note of the authoritative pages, especially those without the nofollow tag, because you may want to reference them as well. So these are the important information you need when doing SERP analysis. You can explore the other tabs if you want to. Now, doing SERP analysis this way takes time, and I want to present you with an alternative, which is to use AI to analyze the SERP. If you have one of these Content AI subscriptions, when you are writing an article, you can visit the Content AI tab and you will see the research feature. Add your target keyword here, choose your audience location, and hit research. Give it a while for the AI to scrape and analyze the top results, and it will provide you with smart suggestions, such as the word count range, which is what we need, the number of internal and external links to add, the different heading counts, recommended number of images and videos, the main keywords and the frequency that should be used in the content, together with the related keywords, and then the keywords that should be used in the headings, the SEO title and description, the questions you need to answer for the topic, as well as any credible external sources you should link to. Sometimes you may not find any credible sources. It really depends on the niche and topics. If it is a medical or finance topic, which needs a lot of references, you will find a lot of credible links here. So this is a really quick and convenient way to analyze a SERP, but with all this information, you are just going to create a content that is a little better than the rest, because these are data and information that already exists. To stand out from your competitors, you need to give your content an edge by finding this. Content gaps are important information or key details that your competitors missed. For example, when you search for keywords like best yoga mats for beginners, after spending time reading the contents of your top competitors, you realize that they are lacking user testimonials and a video that compares different yoga mats that are popular among beginners. Those are content gaps. Another example would be someone searching for the keyword fastest WordPress hosting. And when analyzing the top results, you realize no one actually provides authentic research data to determine the fastest hosting, or their contents are not in depth. That's a content gap. If you go to the comment section of those articles and see what the users are asking or complaining about, and if those articles did not address those issues, that is a content gap. And if you find the information on the top ranking articles outdated or references old products or information, that's a content gap as well. Having these elements that are helpful to the searcher will make your content stand out from your competitors. You need to put yourself in the shoes of people searching for the keyword and determine what they are expecting and looking for. And that's how you identify content gaps. So what do you think? Do you now understand how to do proper SERP analysis? Do you think there is something that I've missed? Let us know in the comments down below, and don't forget to smash that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic, and if you haven't subscribed to us, do consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.